joins me now. Joe was Democratic National Chairman during President Clinton's second term, an early supporter of Senator Clinton in her run for president. Now the influential Indiana Democrat is switching teams, backing Senator Obama. Thanks so much, Joe, for joining us. First of all, why?
Well, thank you, Andrea. You know, these are tough and personal decisions, I think, for every superdelegate that's been involved. But over the past year, I've learned, like millions of people across America, about Barack Obama, someone who I did not know before and had no personal relationship with. And I think what I've learned is the same thing that has inspired so many people across this country, that this is someone who really, truly believes that we can address serious solutions, serious problems that Americans have, without playing the old political games that I myself have been such a part of, as someone who's sparred with everyone from Lee Atwater to Karl Rove. He's different. We've seen this past week that he's different and how he's handled the controversy over his former minister, and maybe even more importantly, the controversy around getting rid of the gas tax. These are things that are not that are politically expedient. They're clearly not things that can help him, but I think they've defined his character, and for me, that's what was important. But the fact that whether I'm from Indiana or not from Indiana, is not what this is about. What it's about is, as the former chairman of our party, trying to be able to make those superdelegates who haven't made a decision yet feel comfortable about doing so. There's a lot of important primaries left. Millions of people are going to come out and vote for John McCain, but because he's the presumptive nominee, they get to rally around him as well. I think it's time after next Tuesday that we have a presumptive nominee, that we heal the rifts, we heal the wounds, we rally around Barack Obama and go about beating John McCain.
Joe, there are reports that you did not call the Clintons to explain this before you went public. Have you talked to them at all?
No, I didn't call Barack Obama, and I didn't call Hillary Clinton. That's part of this political theater here again, Andrea, where
some people would call it just plain politeness, since you were switching.
No, this is not a dinner party we're about. This is about fighting for a better America. What happens when you call up, let's say to how Bill Richardson did, and then every reporter wants to ask you what the candidate said, what Bill Clinton or Hillary Clinton said, and then critical of what they said. I'm not going to try to engage in that as well. I'm sure they would be polite and have a great conversation. I'm sure if I had called Barack Obama, he would have said something polite. I'm standing up for what I believe in and talking about what I'm saying, and I'm not going to get involved in the old kabuki political theater here.
Connect to Indianans.
Well, I think he's doing so. I think he's doing so because of the fact that he is not doing the politically expedient thing. And Hoosiers see through that, right? They see through politicians that promise something that might put an extra, you know, $28 in their pocket, a half a tank of gas, like this gas tax idea, but recognize what we need is a real energy policy. We need a real way to try to address the environmental concerns that will affect our kids' lives as much as ours as well. So I think he's doing that. And Andrew, as you can tell, I mean, the polls aren't going well for him right now. If I were opportunistic, I would have stuck exactly where I was. But the way that he's handling himself under this pressure, showing this tenacity and showing the temperature and tone that I think that it takes to be a great president in tough times are exactly why I've made the decision I have.